What is up, guys? AQ is coming in hot. Phase 5 releases in less than a week. And with that, we need to be prepared for the largest content drop in World of Warcraft Classic's history. And as Phase 5 actually drops, there's going to be a lot of things you want to do day one, and that is things like the Darkmantle quest, which I've already done a video exactly detailing how to do all of it, but today I want to focus on getting your new incredible trinket, Earthstrike. So we are going to break down exactly how to get Earthstrike day one of Classic, and this is going to be a lot harder than you guys think, or at least a lot longer of a quest chain than you guys think. So with that said, of course, if you like my content, please like and subscribe. My name is Sarth, and let's get right into it. Okay guys, so a lot of people have been asking me how they can prep to get Earthstrike. And there's a lot of different ways, but first I'm kind of gonna break down everything you need to do for the quest. There are 56 quests to get Earthstrike at least, because the main quest actually makes you turn in 56 other quests just to get the item. And that's not even counting the first quest where you have to go kill a 5-man boss, which I'll break down for you guys, and it is soloable. And as well, there is a lot of quests where you have to farm things, you have to go to different locations, and you need to turn in a lot of pretty much profession items, a lot of pretty random ones. Some are more expensive than others. So let's break it all down. So first, what is Earthstrike? Who wants it and why do you want it? Earthstrike is a trinket that increases your melee and ranged attack power by 280 for 20 seconds with a 2-minute cooldown. So it's a very, very short cooldown. You're gonna be popping this all the time, even on trash. It's gonna be extremely useful in AQ because there's a crazy amount of trash, and having 280 extra attack power when you're cleaving, if you are a warrior, a rogue, a hunter, this is going to be massive. You'll also need this as a Feral Druid or a Rhett Paladin, so let's see what you need. Now, Earthstrike is the item that you get from the quest from Cenarion Circle Exalted. But the interesting thing here is you don't need to be exalted to get the quest. I'm pretty sure you don't even need to be friendly to get this quest. But there are a crazy amount of quests that you do, again, like I said, at least 56 quests that you do while you're on this specific quest. And each of these do give you rep, so an important thing that you should actually know is you don't actually need to have farmed Exalted yet. You should be into Revered, and this should bring you pretty close to Exalted when you're finishing all of the quests, and then you can just turn in Twilight Texts or run like an AQ20 and get the rest of your rep. Okay, so I actually have a friend who had access to a realm that allowed him to do the quest and send me a lot of this footage, so it was extremely helpful. So the first thing you do in this chain is to go up to this NPC, Windcaller Kaldun, and you want to accept two separate quests from him. He gives you both Field Duty and Cenarion Battle Gear. Field Duty is the quest that's the most important right now. Cenarion Battle Gear, you don't actually need to accept right now. All it does is allow you to accept the quest to get Earthstrike. It just has you turn around and talk to this other NPC behind him, the blacksmithing NPC named Vargas. And once you talk to Vargas, he will let you accept the quests to receive different gear from each of the levels: Friendly, Honored, Exalted, Revered. And so the Revered quest actually gives some incredible bracers for casters. There's a lot of really good items here, but we're specifically focused on the one from Exalted, which gives you Earthstrike. And what it requires of you is to bring him 15 Cenarion Combat Badges, 20 Logistic Badges, and 20 Tactical Badges, as well as one Mark of Cenarius, and we'll actually talk about that really fast first. So the Mark of Cenarius is from the quest The Four Dukes. And this quest, all it has you do is go and kill all of the dukes here in Silithus. Anyone can summon them, you just need to kill them. It's pretty easy to get done. This is the quest that you've been doing for rep all along. It'll be harder to get done day one, mainly because a lot of people will be in Silithus, so it might be harder to actually find the stones themselves, because they are at the Twilight Cultist camps, and after they're used, they do go on CD. But It shouldn't be very hard, and finding a group for this is very easy. Also, this is the last thing you really need to do in the quest. So now we need to get the badges, the logistics, combat, and tactical. Once again, we need 15, 20, and 20. That is 55, and each one of these is given to you individually from a quest. So as Alliance and Horde, you head to your respective war effort area. You head down here, and as Alliance, it's right up here, and then you're gonna talk to your quest giver, which for Horde is the mob named Krug Skullsplit. After you talk to him, there's gonna be a little bit of RP, and then he's gonna summon a giant Silithid mob. This mob is soloable, but technically it should be done with like 2 to 5 people. But he is soloable specifically because you have all of these grunts and Krug as well fighting with you. And if you run away, or if you faint as a rogue or feign death as a hunter and as a warrior, you just like kind of range the mob, he'll just tether and aggro back onto the grunt and keep attacking them. So just try not to grab aggro and you can solo this. The convenient thing here is you only need to do this quest one time, but you will need to talk to Krug Skullsplit a lot. I guess I should also mention that the mob is stunnable and CC-able a little bit, and he doesn't really have many mechanics. He has a charge, a thunderclap, a fear, and I don't know if there's really anything else. It's a very simple fight. Once you kill the mob, or before, while you're waiting for the RP, click on the unsigned field duty papers that was given to you at the beginning of the quest, and it'll just turn into the prepared field duty papers. What you're gonna do with that is basically just turn it into Krug Skullsplit. That's literally it, but you have to kill the mob first. Once it's dead, talk to Krug again, turn in those field duty papers, and he will give you the signed field duty papers, which you will now return to Cenarion Hold. Back at Cenarion Hold, you'll turn in these field duty papers, and he will give you the option from 1 of 3 assignments: combat assignment, tactical assignment, and logistical assignment. It doesn't really matter what you choose. The combat ones are the ones I chose first, and I would actually suggest choosing the combat ones first, because what they give you is a dossier for one specific hive. And then when you click the dossier itself, it will give you 4 different quest items that each give you 4 different quests to kill 4 different types of mobs or elite silithids in those hives. This is a grind, guys. These have you sometimes killing up to 30 of these elites, and you might only find clearing out the entire hive maybe 10 to 15. But if you're helping someone farm Scarab Lord, it would be useful to be doing both of these quests at the same time while you're helping farm Scarab Fragments. Now, all of these combat tasks, when you complete them, will give you 1 Cenarion Combat badge. Again, we need to get 15 of these. So be ready to be doing a lot of these Silithid kills. Before you go off though and start doing this quest, you can actually pick up multiple of every quest. So make sure you have a lot of room in your inventory. And as you pick up the quest from Windcaller Kaldin, just pick up another field duty from him. All you have to do is run back to the original quest giver that is at your war effort place, turn in the papers. So make sure you click the papers because they're unsigned originally. Then you get a signed field duty paper, head back to Windcaller Kaldin and turn it in and pick up another one. You can get more combat ones at the same time. You can pick up multiple tactical ones at the same time. You can pick up multiple logistic ones at the same time. And the important thing with those is if you don't like the logistic ones you picked up, then you can just delete it and get another one. The only hard part here, or annoying part, it's not even hard, is that you have to run back and forth each time to pick up another quest. But it's just pretty much time consuming, running back and forth. So with the combat ones, it's literally just sending you to one of the hives and you just kill a lot of the mobs in that hive. It's very simple. It's pretty much just a farm. And again, if you are helping someone with Scarab Lord and you are deputized, you can pick up Scarab Fragments while you do this. The tactical one actually gives you a few different quests. Some of the quests are to go kill different mobs. Some of them are to kill mobs that you have to summon, like pretty much the same thing as the Dukes, but the weaker versions of them. Some of them have you go into different hives and find scouts, because there's a scout within each different hive, and they're kind of hiding within one of the caves of each hive. Some of them are easier to find, some of them are harder to find, so you might want to look it up when you get the quest in particular. So the tactical one adds a lot of variance, while the combat one is pretty much just a massive farm. The last one is the logistics. And the logistics is the one that is more expensive than it is time consuming. You can fully prepare for the logistic one right now. And the reason for that is because whatever logistic quest you get, it will ask you to turn in something, which is always going to be an item from some sort of different profession, or multiple items. For example, to get the Cenarion logistical badges, there are all of these quests: band-aids, arms, desert survival kits, and if you see, look, it actually, this one will require you to turn in 30 heavy rune cloth bandages, 30 heavy mage weave, and 30 heavy silk bandages. Some are more expensive than others, like I mentioned. This other one is for 2 moonsteel broadswords, and it just kind of ranges. Some of them have you turning in smoked desert dumplings, powerful anti-venom, gloves of water. And I actually recorded a bit where I went through every single one of these, and I realized it was kind of tedious, and I was gonna put together a spreadsheet when somebody actually messaged me, knowing I was making the video, that Frost actually made a video kind of similar to this. And he actually made a spreadsheet breaking this down entirely. So here's the spreadsheet from FrostLive, and it is pretty incredible. I will link this in the description as well as his video if you missed it. But there are 2 quests that are Horde only, and there's 2 quests that are Alliance only, but it breaks down exactly what each of the quests require for you to turn in. And for the Exalted quest, you might need about 4 to 5 times of each of these. So say one quest for the Boots of the Guard, take 3 ornate mithril boots to turn in, just for 1 logistical badge, by the way. And that's 42 mithril bars, 6 true silvers, 12 thick leathers, 3 solid grinding stones, and 3 aquamarines. So this is exactly where things get very expensive, because you need 20 of these badges. And warriors also, I think, need to do the revered quest, so this is going to be very expensive. I would suggest stocking up on these ASAP, like literally this weekend, because pretty much everything here is going to go up in price, especially for week 1. And if you want to get this item very fast, you're going to want to just pretty much turn in this part and then move on to the tactical and combat missions. And that's pretty much it, guys. Farming your Earthstrike day 1 is going to be a huge boost to your DPS, and you don't actually need to farm it day 1 because it's going to be very hard. It's going to be a very long grind, but getting it before you get into AQ will be pretty massive. You can help your Scarab Lord farmers in your guild while you are doing these quests. The quests are extremely repetitive and there's a lot of them. Again, you need to turn in at least 56 of them just to get Earthstrike. But they do all give you rep, so you can work on your rep grind while you're doing the quests. Now, as usual, thank you guys all for watching. I do appreciate it. If you want to see any sort of content in general, just leave a comment in the comment section. Make sure to like and subscribe. It helps the YouTube algorithm a ton, and I know that's kind of cheesy to say, but it's pretty nice. As always, if you want to see me doing any of the quests or any of the farms, you can come hang out with me at twitch.tv/sarth. I do stream every Tuesday, Monday, Friday and Saturday, 7 p.m. PST, Saturdays, 4 p.m. PST. Although I am taking a quick break from streaming this first week while I do a bit of the farms, so we'll see when I'm live. You can follow me on Twitter to find that out. Thanks again for watching, and everybody, good luck out there. Get yourself Earthstrike day 1 or week 1. Crush it. Good luck to the people farming Scarab Lord, and I'll see you guys all in AQ.